Morning, it's day 144. This mountain in front of us is the one that we're going to be climbing today. We've just been dropped off at the car park here by Bill, who picked us up from the motel last night. And just through there, you'll see, is the sign that says Appalachian Trail to the left. We've just been dropped off at this car park, and there's a couple here who are doing trail magic, and they're making pancakes. We've got brownies, they've even got some Jack Daniels, and they've got some beer that Simon's just testing, just seeing if he likes it this morning, just to give him that bit of energy before we climb this huge mountain. So yeah, we've got a 10-mile climb today, and it's going to be interesting. So we're heading for the lake in the clouds. So we shall speak to you when we're right up there.
So we're climbing up Webster Mountain. You have to excuse pockets. Do that pose again. What he's doing, we were watching Rocky last night, and I think she thinks she's on the steps of Philadelphia. So that's where we're going up there. But the view is astounding.
That's pretty cool.
Say again. We'll stay here then. About 2.5 hours, and we've had so many views already. The day's beautiful, very windy here, obviously. There's boats down there. Miles and miles and miles of mountains. That'll be the next peak. We'll be up to about 15 minutes. Great. Lots of fresh air. It's not really humidity anymore, but the first climb, first 40 minutes were brilliant, brilliant day climbing up. It's good, it's right here. Yes, we're going to crack on. Hey, it's 4:15. And we have climbed all the way from somewhere over there, up off route 302 at the Webster Cliffs. Yeah, is that right?
I think so. It's ever so windy.
Ever so windy. This mountain here right in front of you is Mount Eisenhower. We're heading... I'll just show you the views first before we're going. It's just speechless here. So tomorrow morning, that's where we'll be. Mount Washington. Certainly hope those clouds aren't the same colour above it tomorrow. I haven't really got a lot to say really, it's just magnificent, wouldn't, isn't it? Been a tough steady climb. Once you got above tree line and you've got something to occupy your mind with, the climbing seems to go quite well. But I'll just stand here and show you, I'm going to show you tomorrow anyway, but where I'm stood, I will take you all the way around. Like I said, speechless. I don't think I'd be able to pick them out for you, but even in that distance there, right the way in the faintest of skylights, it's still mountains.
Hi guys, so it's the end of the day. 11.6 miles I think it is today, and we've been up and over quite a lot of these rocky mountains. We've come down the trail down here to, oh look, it's a bit windy, to this building here, which is called Lake in the Clouds. This building holds, well, there's eight bunk rooms, and each bunk room has about between 12 and 15 bunks in, and they charge $100 a night, or you can work for stay, and we're doing the latter, unfortunately. But what it means is that we get to sleep inside here, at least it's in the warm. And we've just got to help out with breakfast in the morning, which is one of them things, really. We're certainly not paying $100. If we had our own private room and bathroom, we'd be alright. But yeah, this is Lake in the Clouds, quite a famous place. I'm just going to walk you around here to show you the big climb in the morning. So, there's Firefly, all wrapped up, ready for winter.
Ready for winter.
And, oh, Mount Washington is just there, and we can't see the top of it at the moment because it's in the clouds. Hold on, sorry. So it's up there. So that's where we're going tomorrow, and we're not sure whether it's going to be cloudy or what, so we'll see what happens in the morning. So we shall see you tomorrow. Good morning, it's day 145, and there is the top of Mount Washington that we're going to be climbing in about probably half an hour if we're lucky. Obviously this is where I showed you last night, where we stayed, called Lake in the Clouds. And all these hikers here have had breakfast, so we're just waiting now to wash up the dishes after them. But yeah, looking forward to this climb today at the top there. There's a restaurant up there, believe it or not, and there's a train that you can take as well, but obviously we're hiking. Nice morning, yeah, a bit fresh, but it's looking good. Forecast rain showers later, so with a bit of luck we'll be hopefully somewhere near the end by the time they come. But when we get to that top there, that's Mount Washington, we will let you know.
So the summit of Mount Washington, got up just in time. Alison's about 10 minutes behind me, but I've rushed up. Oh, dear me, huge climb. And I left her behind because I saw this coming in. In about another 2 minutes, there is going to be no view up here. And just for once on this journey, I know Alison's not going to see it, but she'll see the video. But if we stayed together, we wouldn't have got the video. And it's coming in absolutely immediately. I'll show you now. Here we go. We'll just watch down there. It's actually reasonably mild. I mean, I'm only in a t-shirt. It's going to be gone in less than 5 minutes. It's coming in quick. I mean, there's a view behind us. Here's a view here. So it's almost gone. Oh well, I'm going to go get on some drink now. I'm pretty sure she's going to need it. So we're in the cafeteria at Mount Washington, and somebody could have told us there was an easier way of getting up. There's the train, the people coming up now for the day to summit Mount Washington. Absolutely brilliant.
Yeah, it is. Now that came up from the back side, from the front side, whichever you want.
Well, we've been off Mount Washington about just under an hour now. And it's cold, we've got our jackets on, extremely cold. Forecast a heavy day of rain tomorrow. Alison's just standing down there looking at me. Wave again. Alison. Wave again. So she's carrying on. We're going to go up there again, up into that summit in the clouds, and over to the right, and then down the other end. Looks pretty easy on the camera, but it's been magnificent in this state, absolutely. Very difficult. We're not used to the mileage that we've been having to do compared to what we used to do, but you can only do what you're allowed. This is what's underfoot at the moment, and has been for the last hour. So unfortunately, we're getting that close now. It's a question of taking time. One slip, one injury now. Would be a huge disappointment. So it's been like this. As you can see, it continues to be like that. And I'm pretty sure, looking at that peak there, you can just see the trail there at 12 o'clock going all the way up. All the way up there. So that's going to be the best part of our day today, I think. Anyway, better go catch the girl up.
It's the end of the day, and we've climbed Mount Washington.
We have.
And Mount Madison.
Yeah, that was a brute.
It was.
A descent. As tough as anything that I've done this year. You think?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm going to have a look now and just see.
We've done 13 miles today. We did a bit of work for stay this morning where we stopped and made bunk beds. But we were quite lucky because we were out of the Lake of the Clouds by 8:30. And they did say that work for stay, you don't normally get out till 9:15. So we had quite a good start this morning. The weather's been quite kind, but that's about it. It's been tough on your feet. Really, really tough on our feet.
Absolutely.
So we found this little spot just here where we're just going to be setting up our tent in just a minute. We're just having something to eat first. What time is it now?
8 o'clock.
But it's 8 o'clock now and we've literally just stopped.
Yeah.
So we've got big climbs again tomorrow.
Yeah. Tomorrow, is it the Wildcats?
Wildcats tomorrow.
And just to make it a bit more interesting, forecast rain all day.
Forecast rain.
But we're trying to get into the hostel, aren't we, for Tuesday?
Yeah, yeah. So we've done a few extra miles today, which helps for tomorrow.
Yeah.
We were going to stay at a campsite, which was 2 miles away, but we just pushed on today. And we'll be up at 6 in the morning.
We'll be gone for 6 in the morning.
Up and away for 6 in the morning. So keep your fingers crossed for us that we don't have no rain in the night. We can pack away a dry tent. And then if we have showers, we have showers over the Wildcats.
Yeah. Yep.
So we'll see you in the morning. Mm-hmm. Oh, we did forget to say, the end of the day yesterday, we met somebody on the trail who we saw in...
North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Just outside Franklin.
And she said to us, she was waiting at the roadside with Trail Magic. And we were very pleased to see her, actually.
Yeah.
Wild child.
Yeah, pleased to see you yesterday as well.
And we passed her. She's going southbound.
Coming towards the Webster Cliffs.
Yeah.
And it was great.
We looked at her and we pointed and, oh my God, I remember seeing you in Franklin and we passed her going southbound. And she actually commented on one of our YouTubes, hopefully we'll pass each other. And we did yesterday, so good luck to you on your journey.
Yeah, absolutely. It was great to see you, by the way.
Yes, yeah.
Just stay safe.
Yeah, and that's about it, really. So we'll see what holds us for tomorrow.
Yep. So morning, day 146. That's what's welcomed us into this new day. It's dry. Forecast not a great day, not a great day tomorrow, but sometime tomorrow afternoon, early evening, we'll be at a hostel anyway. Slept really well. It's really difficult out here sometimes getting in between spaces and campsites so far apart. But we're going to try and make it up through here today. Alison's ready to go. Backpack just wants finishing off. Try and get it up over the wildcats today and make sure we definitely get over Wildcat E, which we've been told is the most difficult climb, which is the first one for us and the last one for southbounders. So we should be there, I would think, about 7:30, 7:45 this morning. If we could just get the weather to hang off till midday, get us up the rocks, it'd be a great, great bonus. Anyway, how you feel?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Sleep okay?
Not bad.
Not bad. All right, then we're going to crack on. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. So, start climbing Wildcat E. This is the terrain, rock face all the way up there. So anybody who thinks the Appalachian Trail is like the film titles it, A Walk in the Woods, we'll see. Alison is here. There is the main road. And I don't know if we can actually see what we've scaled over. We've just climbed all the way up around this edge. So, sorry. There's the views we have. There's how far away the road is. And it's exceptionally steep. And of course, it's raining. So it's still raining, but we've climbed the first phase. I'm just going to show you a view of what we're looking at. And it's a real miserable day, but you know what? I could be at work. This is what we're looking at. And that is just immense through those clouds. In fact, when I finish this video, I'm going to take a photograph of that. Morning, July 25th. I don't know, 47 I think, or 45. We came off, well, we tried to complete all the Wildcat Mountains last night. And the weather was just atrocious all day. We stopped off at the hut by the lake, but there would have been no way we would have made 15 miles through this, looks great now, these boardwalks, through this terrain this morning. So we carried on, we got up to the 4,500 peaks, and the wind, I would actually say on July the 24th, it was the worst winter's day since North Carolina.
Yeah.
We came down, it was getting late, 8 o'clock, it was getting dark. We were having 30, 40 foot rock slide downs. Looking to...
We know
our poles have been packed away since 7 o'clock yesterday morning. And it's been rock scrambling all day yesterday. And then last night, we came down the trail and we're at a low spot, wide enough, bang, smack in the middle of the AT for our tent. It was 8 o'clock. 8:15, we knew nobody else was walking. No, there was no other fools, put it that way. And we just pitched our tent there. It rained through the night, the wind howled. And it's the first time ever today we had water on the inside of the tent through our ground sheet and through the bottom of the tent. Obviously, we may have took 30% of that in off our gear. But when we got up this morning, we were lying in a quagmire. So, our rain jackets are totally soaked. We're fortunate we're going to a hostel, so everything can get cleaned in that and we can get showered and warmed up. I'm not particularly cold at the moment. How do you feel?
Bedraggled.
That's a good word. Alison's even got trousers on. So yeah, we've got about an 8.5 mile descent now to get to where we're going. And it's tough. It's been really tough. Yesterday was tough. It was a bit like hiking at home. Misty days, cold rain, howling wind. Yeah, so it was typically British weather. So I did, you know, you moan when it's hot and humid, you moan when it's cold and wet. So I preferred to walk yesterday. But I just knew last night when the dark was setting in, trying to get down these wet rocks just wasn't happening for us. And what I'm showing you now, this is nothing. I'm talking 60, 70 degree pitches. And when you've only got slight areas like that to slide a foot into, it's a little bit scary. Alison had a little bit of after all that, yeah. Alison had a tumble on a root, but she's okay. And it was a bit dirty, but I don't know. There you go. There's a slip there now, on camera. So I'm going to go, because we've got to get down here and get ourselves sorted out. Hi, it's 6 Hi. O'clock, and it's like a different world. We're down in Gorham. We got to the hostel really nice, isn't it?
Yeah, got half 12, so we've washed, showered, laundried.
Laundried.
Had a bite to eat.
We're
just waiting for a pickup now to take back to the hostel.
Well, we're going to go to Walmart first, aren't we? Yeah. We only want a few bits.
So, yeah.
It's a full day tomorrow and then half day and we'll be in Maine.
Yeah, and our tent's all drying, so
yeah.
When we get back, we can pack that away and it'll be dry.
Yeah, Alison's got. Let's have a look. New Keen Duran boots, the ones she had originally, and then we tried a new style of Keen that were about as much use as a chocolate teacup. So she's gone back to the original ones. They should see her through now. Mine aren't in the worst condition.
So they just split so quickly.
Yeah, they were cheap. They weren't good quality ones at all.
Made they were lightweight, weren't they?
Here so we go. I don't want to upset everybody. Made in Vietnam.
No, but they were lightweight, so that's why we ordered them.
Yeah.
So these are more heavyweight.
Yeah, American built, Oregon. Portland, Oregon, sorry. So mine are the same, but I've sent them to my cousin Craig in Tennessee.
Because you don't need them yet, do you?
Just make sure you're not wearing them when I get back.
Well, hopefully these were your ones will last us.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, and by the way, don't get wear my watch to work. I'm only kidding. So yeah, it's turned out. Two worlds today. It was so cold last night and this morning.
Looking that way for the shuttle, that's why I'm doing two things at once, because I can multitask. Well, look, shuttle camera, see?
Okay. All right, so, with that comment, we'll speak to you guys tomorrow. Morning. It's 8 o'clock. It's day 148. And this is the hostel, White Mountains Lodge and Hostel. I just went to Pinkham Notch this morning with a driver to fetch a package that was sent. We missed it the first time around when we climbed over the Wildcats. So thanks, guys. I've got the chocolates. Alison says thank you. Pack weighs a ton. It's probably the nearest to £40 it's ever been. Just sort of thing before we start climbing Maine. And we're about just over a day away from the border. Alison's just packing her bits and bobs, putting her boots on, her new boots. My boots have gone home, because they've gone home. Gone to my cousin's, I'll take them home with me. The key and I've got on will have to make Maine. So how are you this morning?
Yep. Ready to go.
Another
day.
So we're looking at 12 miles to the shelter, Gentian Pond. The driver told us today, really, really beautiful, beautiful shelter. He said, actually says it's the best shelter now north till Maine. So we're at about 14.2 miles a day now. We have to do to summit on the 15th. We do have 2 days extra if we have to. We do have 4 days extra, but I don't want to because I want to go out to see my cousin. So we're going to go now because we've got to get across this road. Anything you want to add?
No, just, we'll just carry on.
Lady of few words. So I've been climbing 3 hours, and as on most days in New Hampshire, once you get above tree line, this is what you're totally rewarded with. Don't know if that went a little bit out of focus then. All the way around, there's trees behind us, but on this edge we're on, all the way across there. It's a glorious day. It's warm. There in the distance, below the clouds today, there's Mount Washington. It's absolutely perfect up here at the moment. So yeah, we came from somewhere, I don't know, I'm not talking out of rubbish, but we definitely came from down there. There's a town down there, but at the moment our packs are so heavy, we've got that much food, I think we could actually make Maine. But we're going to crack on and walk for another, it's half 11, another hour. And obviously those two peaks are going to get further and further away now. I'm going to crack on for lunch.
It's the end of the day and we're eating our chunky chocolate chip cookies. We're staying in the shelter because forecast rain tonight. We've done 12 miles today.
Are you going up or down?
Hot chocolate
I'm going down
and cookies.
Okay.
This is the shelter. Can't really see it too good, but there's four people up there, right. Two over there, and we're just here. So we've swept it all out, and this is the view that we've got in front of us, which is pretty cool actually. Grey clouds are coming in, apparently about 2 o'clock in the morning. So we decided not to get the tent out and have to walk with a heavy wet tent tomorrow.
Very kind of you.
Simon, walk with a wet tent tomorrow. But our packs are quite heavy because we've done a resupply and we've got some goodies. So it's been a long day again, hasn't it, really? 12 miles.
Last mile,
yeah.
Last mile and a half.
But it will be what it will be.
I keep saying that. Yeah, we'll be all right. A couple more days.
Yeah. Yep. So, we'll see you, we'll speak to you in the morning.
We will. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's day 149. And we stayed at the Gensham Pond campsite last night. Probably one of the most amazing views from a campsite. Although it's got a pond, the water was warm. It was a beaver's dam right where the flow of the water goes. And
we're having a little chuckle because
149 nights. And
somebody was sick.
There was
shelter.
Well, we slept in earplugs, didn't we?
Yeah.
And at 11:30, we jumped to him. Could hear, rah, rah, and I thought, Christ, a bear has got one of the hikers.
Oh no!
And then I thought, shit, when they mean we get up to that, it could be Bigfoot.
Loose.
Oh, it's Bigfoot. But no, it was a guy.
We
on the upper
bottom,
bunk.
And they were on the top.
Drunk.
He was at the top.
Being sick. Now, I'm just imagining this to everybody out there as well. Imagine them moments when you've come home and you feel you're not going to make it through the night. Then imagine putting yourself in a sleeping bag. I cannot think of a worse body heat retention anyway.
There was 10 in the shelter.
Yeah,
and
there was
at the top.
And there was
then,
a guy.
Unfortunately, next to me, the guy, the sick, dripped down.
Dripped down.
Onto
I think
the guy
it
next,
poured down.
Onto the guy his, next door to me.
His down sleeping bag, his coat, everything was covered. As you can imagine, he wasn't
was
best.
Nice.
He wasn't best pleased either.
No.
And the lad was so drunk, he fell out of the shelter. And it's 3 feet up. So we've got two other hikers coming now who could add their version to the story also.
I'll take the cold, wet night.
But yeah. It was 11:30, but because I'd got earplugs in, the sound, I thought somebody was being eaten. You know, sorry guys.
That's okay.
It was just, yeah, that way, yeah.
Yeah.
Catch you later, yeah. We know the guys, so obviously we're not going to name them.
Name names.
No,
but,
but they had a pint bottle
in a brown bag,
funny enough. And the guys just passed us, said he ate, but I didn't see him eat. And, you know, a long day hiking. Your body's worn down anyway. We've all done things. My mum will watch this video and go, oh, you weren't so clever when you were 9. No, not really. 19. But no,
it was a night.
It was not a great night.
It was horrible.
And now we're walking through to the Mahoosick.
So we're up early, as you can
stones.
Imagine, because I've had no sleep, and we're rocks.
It is funny then.
It is now, it wasn't last night.
The only thing that I felt was for the guy underneath.
Next to me, so oh, thank God it weren't God. In under there.
I mean, Alison actually said, I got up at that time and I went to use the bathroom. And she says, I think he's hit him. I thought, hit him? I'd have chucked him in the river. It was everywhere, it was dripping down. And like I say, he was the unlucky guy to be lying directly below him. And, you know, I heard him mention something about $450 for his sleeping bag. And I thought, oh, dear. But,
another reason not to sleep in the shelter, on the bottom bunk.
On the bottom, yeah. And I actually asked you, didn't I?
Yeah.
Early in the night, I said, do you want to sleep on the top?
Well, if we'd have gone on the top, we'd have had it all next to us anyway. So,
I don't. My blueberry crisp.
Stop it! Don't.
Cliff bar's coming back up. Sorry, we're going to crack on, but
it's not raining at the minute. But
no,
it does forecast rain, so
yeah. Oh dear.
Jensen Pond campsite shelter. Well, nobody's going to see this, but
say that song.
I wouldn't sleep in there
tonight. You know that song? Be young, be foolish, and be happy. He was 2 of the 3 because I don't think he was happy.
No.
All right. So, after a 2-hour climb, we're on Mount Success, heading for Maine. I just thought it's really windy, we'll just stop and show you this panoramic view. It is. It's like looking out of an airplane. I don't think you can get by enough to show you the distance. It's cool, but it's not raining. It is windy, yeah. So we're going to have a bite to eat. We're going to get out of the wind, have a bite to eat. And head for Maine. So, Maine, 281 miles away, Alison Shelford. Did you ever think you'd be here?
Nope.
We're here. We've had a really hard morning. It's going to be really long days. The train is so tough. It's not, it's slow, isn't it?
Slow.
You're capable of doing it. It's capable of doing it. It's just time consuming. So guys,
we're
into the last, well, you're not. And I'm not either. You're in now, yeah, you're in Maine. So we're on the summit of the Eastern Goose Mountain. I don't know what's happened to America's summer this year, do you?
No, I think
it was
only 2
p.m. We've just come down off that peak, all the way down, climbed all the way up. And that's how dark it is at the moment. Beautiful lake down there. Already, when it's such wilderness, so quiet. All the way around. I'm going to be honest, and I don't want to tempt fate, but however, we have not had rain today. Actually, it's a miracle, isn't it? Doesn't forecast on my watch, but just hold that minute, chick. Hold that. Can I if you go on my shoulders? Just going to show you. A bit of a close-up. The mountain range all around us. It's just, I don't know, I ain't got more words now. Absolutely no idea. And that's coming back to the peak we've just come over. And round to a full 360.
It's the end of the day. And we're in a shelter. Again. We only managed to do 9-something miles because the heavens opened and it was raining. Really hard.
think it's the five,
yeah. 10 or so other people here.
I know it's the aluminum body.
And, yeah, we've been to Maine. And it rains in Maine. All afternoon. So it wasn't good. But tomorrow's another day. And hope it stopped raining now. That's outside. Just laying there.
4.6 in it.
Aren't we?
But it's got the supercharger with
the
engine. Yeah. Rain in Maine on our first day. Rain into Georgia on our first day.
Good.
So we're just going to make up some miles tomorrow. And the next day. And the next day. And the next day.
Mm-hmm.
And every day till we finish. Or else Mr. Trump will be on our backs saying, get out. But we're tired, as you can see, because we didn't get a lot of sleep last night. But the shelter's full. So I don't think it's going to be a good night tonight again. But it will be, will be. So, oh, earplugs. Yeah, we've got earplugs. So, we'll see you tomorrow.